parish church and a civic church. And I think these are important aspects of who we are and our role, and we see ourselves here in the city and much broader. I'm Father Nick, and I'm a priest in charge, and I arrived here about 12 months ago. And for those who don't know me, I'm also a city worker. And what's interesting about that is that I genuinely believe that it's through art and culture that we will transform the city. And suddenly I find myself here, with perhaps an opportunity to do that. But it won't happen on my own, and one of the most wonderful things is that I get to join in and collaborate with a number of people as we journey. And I'd like to introduce you also to Stefania. Let me just have just introduce yourself first.
Hello everyone, my name is Stefania Samonte and I'm the founder and president of the London Performing Academy of Music. It's a new music conservatoire born in London in 2021 during the pandemic. And it's a conservatoire focused on diversity and inclusion. And thanks to a platform that I developed, we were able to reach out to disadvantaged students that wouldn't otherwise be able to access music education, including actually the students from Ukraine that Japan here tonight.
And so as a national musicians church, you've taken a role, obviously we do a number of things, but you've taken a very key role, we believe, in being part of celebrating and joining in with musicians, encouraging them in all seasons of life. I mean that not age related, I mean in the context of where one is in their career, but also play a significant part in their well-being, the issues around the musicians industry that there are about equality, diversity, inclusivity, and we want to be part of that. And that doesn't mean we can do it on our own. It means we will do it in joining in with others. That's the only way. And I'm generally very pleased that Bill is here to help musicians and the amazing work that they do. And I think with yourselves and others, I think things can be done, huge things can be done. And I look forward to that. And as I say, on the second part of being a city worker, in the issues in the city where I did music, in the same way that I had to get to put my pen down and come here. And actually, being in the city and the issues that I've had during my career and the well-being and challenges that happen in the city, the most amazing thing is now that as a city worker and a priest in charge, I get to spend many of my days in the most amazing place of sanctuary and get to listen to the most amazing musicians. It probably is the only way I could work in the city now. But this collaboration is enormously important in that, as we spoke about music and we got to know each other, suddenly Stefania shared how she'd been caught in the middle of this storm of, because of her relationships, helping musicians to come over from UK, student musicians. And then we said, well, she said, they need a place to study. They've had extra months in Ukraine where they've lost their studies. And they've come over here to so many loving families who are supporting them, which is amazing. But they're not getting their study, and they're not getting their time to perform, which is key to their career. And if they don't do that, actually their well-being becomes impacted even more so. And Stefania is just the most fabulous person. And I said to her, it's probably going to take us a few weeks to sort this out. She goes, how about Monday? So about 4 weeks ago, we agreed that they're going to use the heading wood room as the musicians initially, and that's going to be, and your tutors and everyone else is going to help them. And they're going to come in and they can do some rehearsing here. And then on a Thursday, they're going to do one of the concerts from 5 to 6 over the coming weeks, and every week it'll do there. So it's probably going to be a lot more, because there isn't just 15 students who are here, there's another at least 40 waiting for visas, and there's probably, as we well know, significant numbers. And I think we all, as we gather, need to be bold voices and not only help those who are coming over. And thank you, Jen and Barbara, for the work that you're doing, definitely, and others,
concert is a celebration of this new partnership between the London Performing Academy of Music and the Hollis Brooker. And I would like to say thanks, first of all, to Father Nick and to the team in the National Institute Church. It would be a better place, you know, to bring the students here in the UK to play music. And then to the worship company of the educators who introduced me to Father Nick, and to the music industry, PPI, I'm a member of the council, and the music industry staff team as well, to help in providing homes and working and scholarship and everything to support them and let them continue the studies. One of them told me when she arrived here, we were talking about the exams and the graduations and the masters and future concerts, and she was like, you know, until yesterday I was in Ukraine and I would wake up thinking, I have not tomorrow. And I'm like, I'm still alive today. And he said, with you, I'm already thinking about 3 years forward. And that's what we want. So we want them to believe that their life now is going to be full of everything that. in Paris, and Russia has just invaded Poland at the end of that war. So that was all about, you know, the resistance against the Russians. So we could not choose a better piece. And the second one was the Transcendental Studies by Liszt, who composed 12. They're so difficult that in theory the pianist and the person who's listening to it is ascending to the sky, you know, coming out of his body because it's so sublime, the music that he performed. And that was called the Chasse. So it's a piece about the snowstorm. So it starts with the snow coming down, and everyone loved that they can see snow and it's white and pure and pure. And then suddenly it becomes a storm that is engulfing everyone. Second piece, it's not going to be Puccini, o mio bambino caro. We're going to have Anna Cecchettina, she's going to sing for us a Ukrainian folk song. So please welcome.
Thank you.
Sparta, so they came together. I mean, she was the first, and then Alice came after, and then she was stuck out for the visa, but this is the happy ending, seeing them playing together. So the next one to perform is the last performer today, is Andrzej Macik. He's our very last student. He arrived just on Saturday, and he's already ready to perform for us one of the most beautiful pieces ever, the Chopin Ballade number one, Largo, Moderato.
Thank you.
by many in the city that at the end of a concert I should not say anything, should let the music speak, and so I apologise now. Partly because I just wanted to say two things. One is, first, please stay and have a drink. There's an area here in the corner which we've now set up, we call it our harmony zone. Thank you, Tessa, for that wonderful suggestion. And an opportunity for you to meet the performers and the musicians. And it's interesting that we are going to do that almost in every concert where we can. And I was particularly influenced by a very well-known orchestra, blind, who runs a blind and partial sighted orchestra, who said that he's often invited to play, but so often nobody talks to him afterwards. I don't judge people for that, but you've got to be part of a society that helps us come together to see past what we see first. And so please, they will be gathering over there, please help yourself to a drink and perhaps have a chat, and they can perhaps share their story and share their gifts, which would be wonderful. And secondly, by being here, you are already being wonderful supporters, so thank you for that. And we look forward to hopefully seeing you at other weeks as we, as they share their gifts more over the coming weeks. And I think it's in 2 weeks' time that our concerts will start every week from 5 to 6 here. If we will have a retiring collection, there is a lot to be done to help, and if you would like to, please do. But otherwise, please just enjoy the time. And I will just say a cheeky request, if anybody knows anybody who has a concert piano that's sitting in an annex or somewhere, ours isn't good enough for these students. Now, it's okay, but we would love if there are opportunities for those who know to get in touch, we would appreciate that. And finally, I'd like to invite Stefania and all the musicians back on, please, just to say thank you.
Почему?